Hello friends, today we are going to learn how to add a Metahuman character to the True Fighting Game engine. So, I have duplicated a True FGE project and renamed it to True FGE Tutorial for convenience. Let's start it. First of all, to import a Metahuman, we need to enable the Quixel Bridge plugin. So, let's go to Edit, Plugins. Search for Quixel and enable the bridge. The editor prompts us to restart. Let's do this. All right. Now let's open the content drawer, right click on the empty space and select Add Quixel Content. The Quixel bridge opens. Let's go to the local folder. I already have some Metahumans and I'm going to add this one. I select the highest quality and press the Add button. Alright, so it has been added to the project. We may now close the bridge. And the editor prompts us to enable some plugins. Let's enable them. And we now have to restart once again. Let's now open our content drawer and go to the True FGE demo characters. And let's add one more folder under the characters. And name it Metahuman. Now let's go to our Metahumans and open the folder for our imported Metahuman. In my case, it is Melee 3. And let's drag this blueprint into the Metahuman folder we have just created. And select Copy here. Let's go to that Metahuman folder. And let's rename this blueprint. Let's type here True FGE Amelia 3. And let's open it to edit. It is still compiling materials. All right. We see that hair disappear. It often happens with the Metahuman hair because some of the assets are still under development. Let's select our body and search for bones. And check this include component location into bones. Alright, but we actually need to select all the components under the body as well. Fit. Legs, torso, face, just control and select them with the left mouse click and check the same option for them as well, include component location into bounds. Right, let's save and compile. Now, let's go to the class settings and here under the class options. For the parent class, we select the True FGE base character. It is using the UE5 skeleton and we will retarget its animation blueprint to our Metahuman in real time. So, to do so, let's select our body component and drag it to the mesh. And it is now a child of the mesh. And we can now select and delete this root component. Now, let's select the body component and find the variable named retarget mode enabled. Select it and in the details tab, set it to be true. Alright. Now, we select the mesh and we search for tick. And here for the visibility based anim tick option, We select Always Tick Pause and Refresh Bones. Now, let's select our body once again and set its location and rotation to the default values. And now we want to make this queen mesh invisible. So we select the mesh, search for Visi, and disable this visible option. All right. Now, let's select the root component and set the name for our character. In the details tab, search for character and let's type here Emilia. And now what we also need to do, as we have inherited this class implicitly, we need to override some of our events. So we go to the event graph, and for this event begin play, we right click and we select add call to parent function. All right. And we just drag a connection here. And here. And we do the same for this event. And for the event tick. Fine. And now we also go to the construction script and we do the same for the construction script. Click it, add call to parent function, and we drag a connection here and here. And now we compile and save. All right. Looks good. Let's close this window. Now, we need to add this character to our true FG engine. To do so, open the content drawer, navigate to Content, True FG, Blueprints, Miscellaneous, and open the BP True FG functions. Here at the left, double click the populate characters map. And here we have the make character nodes. Let's select this one as it is for the UE5 skeleton and let's duplicate it. Just click Ctrl D on your keyboard. All right. And we will use the same moveset that we use for Queen and the same heatmap. We will just select a new character blueprint here. Let's set it to the True FG MLA3 that we have just created. Fine. Now, here in the Make Map node, let's right click and select the Add Key Value Pair. For the key, we type the name of our new character. It is Amelia. Do you remember we have just specified it inside our blueprint? And we drag a connection from the character pin to the value. And we compile and save. If you start the game, we see nothing happens because we need to set up the default character. Let's open up the content drawer and navigate to the True FG blueprints. And here we have a blueprint named BP True FG game mode. Let's open it. And here we type Amelia instead of this Queen character. And we compile and save. Let's run the game, and nothing happens once again. This is because the editor didn't manage to update the BP to FGE settings. If you select it here in the outliner, we can see that it only contains three characters now, and our Amelia hasn't been added. It is easy to update it. Let's just delete it from here. Just click on it and press the delete key on your keyboard. And now we go to the content drawer and we drag this BP through FG settings class anywhere to the map. And now it has Amelia. We run the game and it seems to look good. And just one more thing. If we open our content drawer and go to characters metahuman and open the character blueprint once again, we can see that if we select its face, it uses a separate animation blueprint. It is how metahuman works, and it is very convenient because by editing this animation blueprint for the face, we can add expressions to our metahuman. So it will still use the blueprint for the queen animations for its main body. And it can separately use this animation blueprint for its face. And hopefully in one of the next videos, we will talk about this and add some animations to the MetaHuman character. And that's it for today. See you next time. Goodbye.